You know, you can tread on some interesting stories that do or do not belong to you.
Yeah.
Have you encountered that in your writing, where you've said something that maybe was not yours to say? You know those stories, you're in a place.
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of them came up, for example, when I made the conscious decision to include my children and my parenting experiences with the two fictional characters in this book, right up to having Rebecca Hardy be the star of this book.
Right.
You know, because here I am with my daughter, who I love, and who's a lawyer. She's not Rebecca Hardy. You know, I had to walk a very thin line between her and her own precious self, and I mean that, not being silly. Mm-hmm. And I didn't want to abuse that privilege, but I wanted to be able to use it, because she taught me so many lessons about life.
Mm-hmm.
When you're being a dad of a young teenage girl, especially, things, you know, are amazing, and you don't want to mix them up between what you're using for fiction and what is real.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'm very aware of that. Mm-hmm. You know, that whole, and you bring it up, it's a brilliant thought that I don't think anybody's ever mentioned before. Mm-hmm. That whole question about how much of myself is in the book, and how much of my experiences are in the book as mine rather than Dismas's. Mm-hmm.